And now go to run and click on auto run. So here you can see that we have successfully created a square using this MillMaster Pro software. So hello guys, and welcome back to our channel Simple Random Knowledge. So guys, in today's video we are going to see how to download and install this MillMaster Pro software in Windows 10. And also we are going to see the introduction of this MillMaster Pro software, its user interface and its features. And also we are going to perform a basic programming code for a square using this software. So guys, there are 77% of people who are watching this video but they haven't subscribed to my channel. So I genuinely request to all you guys that please do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon near it. So guys, without wasting any more time, let's start with today's video. So guys, first of all go to new tab. Search here MillMaster Pro, and the first result that you will get is a microkinetics.com MillMaster Pro for a Windows. Click on your first link and this kind of interface will be open in front of you. I will directly paste this link in my description. Here you will get option to download. Click on this download. I have already downloaded this software, so I will minimize this browser. So here you can see the setup. So double click on the setup. You will get a prompt, click on yes. This will ask you the destination folder for installing this software. You can browse your folder or you can keep this as default. Click on install and this will take some time.
A few moments later.
So here we have completed the installing this setup. So click on close. So here you can see the setup file and here you can see the software. Double click on the software, click on I agree and then click on OK. So this way you are ready to use this software. Maximize this tab. First of all go to file, click on new. So this kind of user interface you will get. So here by default we have selected tool as a drill and the units are in inch. So as we know in any mechanical software we are supposed to set units first. So go to option, select machine parameter. So here you will get option of units. So click on metric. You will get this kind of prompt, click on this checkbox and click on continue offline. So here you can see the units are converted into mm. Now the next step is to specify the dimension of our workpiece. So go to option, select on material size, give the length as 80 and the width as 80, height as a 10, and here you will get option to specify the location of your origin. I have kept this option as default. Click on write values to the part program. Click on OK. So here you can see the values that we have selected up till now is shown in this part program. So this way we have completed with the pre-processing steps. Now we move to the part programming of this square block. So here you will get option to toggle full screen edit mode. Click on this option. Now I already have written the program for a square block. So I will paste the program. So guys, if you want a detailed video on explanation of all the codes, then please comment below. I will try to make a video on this topic. I will explain this code. So guys, first of all, code consists of different variables and numbers. The N01 state the number of this block. G90 state absolute programming. We have written this code for absolute programming. There are basically two types of programming, absolute and incremental. As the name suggests, incremental codes are dependent on previous steps and absolute codes are independent of previous steps. G71 state the matrix system. G94 state the speed rate in mm per minute. M03 state the rotation of spindle in clockwise direction. S200 state the speed of spindle. And this way we complete the block number 1. We have used semicolon to end this block. And we move to the block number 2. We have numbered this line as N02. G00 state the rapid positioning. If you want to move this pointer from one position to another position, that is defined as a rapid positioning. Then we have specified the starting position of our tool. We have kept X as 0, Y as 0 and Z we have selected as 3. The reason why we are not selecting Z as 3, because if we select the value of Z as 0, then there are chances that tool will touch the workpiece. So we want some offset distance from the workpiece and that offset distance we have selected as 3. Then we have used semicolon to end this block and then we move to the block number 3. Then we have written J01. J01 state the linear interpolation, that means your tool is moving in vertical direction. Then we have specified the coordinates of Z as -10 and the feed rate F is 150. Then we have end this block and we move to the block number 4. We have used J01 and the coordinate of X is 75. We have used a semicolon to end this block, move to the block number 5. And here we have a coordinate of X and Y as 75. I have written the coordinate of Y only. So this software by default select the previous value of the coordinate. We have used semicolon and we move to the block number 6. Here the value of X and Y is 50 and 75 respectively. In line number 7, the value of X is 0. And in line number 8, the tool is coming back to origin. So the value is X as 0 and Y as 0. And at the last block, we have used J00 and M02. M02 state that the program is end. So this way we have completed with the coding part. So again click on this option, toggle full screen edit mode. And now go to run and click on auto run. So here you can see that we have successfully created a square using this MillMaster Pro software. So you can go to files and save this project. So guys, this way in today's video we have seen how to download and install this software. And we have seen how to write a basic code using this software. So guys, if you have liked this video, please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon near it. And share this video among your friends. And if you have not watched my previous videos on FES stress analysis, then I will post a link in description as well as in I button. So until our next video, stay safe and happy learning. Thank you.